We come to the final video on the PN junction. It deals with the PN junction under illumination and connect it with a load. In this lecture, we will derive the charge carrier concentration in the PN junction and the illuminated IV curve. To simplify the derivation of the current and voltage relationship for an illuminated PN junction diode, we have to make some assumptions. The first five assumptions are the same as we made to derive the dark IV curve. We have added a new assumption for deriving illuminated IV curve. We assume a uniform generation rate across the whole PN junction. This assumption is called the uniform generation rate approximation. When a PN junction diode is illuminated, the light is absorbed and extra electron hole pairs are generated in material. The concentration of minority carriers in both P and N-type region strongly increases. So now we would like to know what the minority carrier distribution is in an illuminated PN junction. In order to derive the distribution, we start with the continuity equation for electrons in the P-type region and holes in the N-type region. In quasi-neutral regions and at steady state, we can simplify the continuity equation for electrons and holes to these equations. We see only the diffusion, recombination, and generation terms are present in the equations. To solve these two equations, we need to know the boundary conditions for electrons and holes. With the assumption of Boltzmann approximation, we can use the same boundary conditions as in the analysis of the PN junction in the dark. Once we solve the continuity equations for electrons in the P-type region and holes in the N-type region with boundary conditions, we can find the minority carrier distribution in the quasi-neutral region. So now we arrive at the equation describing the minority carrier distribution. You see, it is a very complex equation with many terms: photogeneration rate, applied voltage, and diffusion length all have influence on the minority carrier distribution. To get a view of the minority carrier distribution, we can plot the carrier concentration profile for an illuminated PN junction when there is no voltage applied. This is the carrier concentration profile of an illuminated PN junction in short circuit condition. The vertical axis is the carrier concentration on logarithmic scale, and the horizontal axis is the position in a PN junction. When a PN junction is illuminated, electron and hole pairs are generated. The rate of minority carrier generation depends on the intensity of light. When we assume uniform generation rate, there is a large increase in the minority carrier concentration and the majority carrier concentration remains almost the same. So you see, the concentration of majority carriers of an illuminated PN junction is the same as that of a PN junction at thermal equilibrium. As we mentioned before, the minority carriers that are generated within the diffusion lengths are able to diffuse to and cross the depletion region. Those minority carriers that are generated at the edge of the depletion region are immediately swept towards the other side. So you see, the minority carrier concentration at the edge of the depletion region is nearly equal to the concentration at thermal equilibrium. As we go away from the edge of the depletion region, the chances of extra minority carriers drifting to the other side of the depletion region decreases. Hence, the concentration of minority carriers increases. The minority carrier concentration in the quasi-neutral region outside the region determined by the diffusion length is at a steady state value and is determined by the generation and recombination rate in the quasi-neutral region. The illuminated JV curve can be derived in a similar way as it has been done for a dark JV curve. Using the fixed first law and by substituting the minority carrier concentration into the equation, we find a current driven by electrons and holes respectively. To find the net current density J, we also need to include the contribution of photocurrent density from the depletion region. As we assume that the current is constant and continuous in a p-n junction, the total current density is the sum of the hole and electron current densities and photocurrent density contributed from the depletion region. So, for the total current density, we get this equation. Now we see the net current density of the illuminated p-n junction diode is the sum of the dark current density and the photocurrent density. When a load is connected to an illuminated p-n junction, the voltage drop at the load can be considered as a forward bias voltage applied to the junction. The equation of photocurrent density indicates that only the carriers generated within the diffusion length from the edges of the depletion region and generated in the depletion region have the chance to be separated and collected. When the light shines on a p-n junction diode, a large drift current due to minority carriers flows from the n-type region to the p-type region. This drift current is called photocurrent. When we look at the illuminated JV curve, we can note that illumination shifts the dark JV curve of the diode downward by an amount of the photocurrent density. The JV curve is shifted downward and the net current density becomes negative. By definition, the direction of current is determined by the flow of positive charge carriers. So the photocurrent density is negative because the holes flow from the n-type region to the p-type region, so in the negative direction. The illuminated JV curve is in the fourth quadrant in the JV graph. The voltage in this quadrant is positive while the current is negative, resulting in a negative power. The negative power delivered by an illuminated p-n junction implies that power is extracted from the device. Hence, an illuminated p-n junction generates power instead of consuming power. From illuminated JV curve, we can determine the most important external parameters that characterize the performance of a solar cell. The short circuit current is the maximum current that flows in a solar cell when an illuminated p-n junction diode is short circuited. In this case, the resistance of the cable is assumed to be zero and there is no voltage drop across the cable. The short circuit current is the photo-generated current. The open circuit voltage is the maximum voltage generated at the electrodes of a solar cell. We can measure the open circuit voltage when terminals of a solar cell are not connected. What interests us is the maximum power delivered by a solar cell. So we plot a power voltage curve. Power is the product of voltage and current. A peak power can be easily detected from the power voltage curve. The voltage and current at the peak power is called voltage and current at the maximum power point. From the ratio of the peak power to the product of open circuit voltage and short circuit current, we get additional external parameter that is called the fill factor. Finally, using these external parameters, we can determine the conversion efficiency of a solar cell. The efficiency of a solar cell is the ratio of the maximum delivered power over the power of incident light, as shown by the equation in this slide. In this week, we discussed the properties, the carrier concentration profile, and the band diagrams of a PN junction diode at thermal equilibrium, at bias voltage conditions, and under illumination. We determined the dark and illuminated JV curves step by step. Understanding the physical properties of a PN junction is important because it is the most important building block of a solar cell.